that we need to calculate. So if A sal B salary, if B salary is first, what is 20% increases, 20% increases, and then 10% decreases. Okay, so let the A salary is, B salary is, sorry, what, 100 right now. Now after increases 20%, I can add this value in this, so my so the B salary become 120 after increasing this 20%, and now B salary is decreased by 10%. So what is 10% of this value? So 10% of this value is what, 12. You need to subtract this value, so this 120 minus 12 will give you 108. Now tell me, how much percentage decreases in B salary? It's
increases by 8%.
Increases by 8%, right? Increases by 8%, right? So increases by 8% salary, not 6%. So this is only for the revision. Okay. Now I'm going to tell you the next question, and that is, am I visible to all of you? Am I visible to all of you?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Look at my hand. Look at my hand. This is A and this one is B. Okay. So my question is, if B salary, this is A, this one is B. Okay. If B salary is 20% higher than A salary, if B salary is 20% higher than A salary, then how much A salary is less than B salary? I repeat my question again. If B salary is 20% higher than A salary, then how much A salary is less than B salary? Can anyone tell me the answer?
20%.
Okay. 20%. Next.
20%.
So everyone got what the question, what I'm asking. If B salary is 20% higher than A salary, then how much A salary is less than B salary? This is the question. Okay. Now I'm going to tell you that if such question, this types of question comes, then how we can deal and how you can attack on that question. Okay. So look at the screen. But before going to the solution, I just give you the process so that you can calculate the value. Suppose if I'm writing over here 100 and at the end of the year, if I'm writing 120, suppose, then we need to calculate two things. Okay. How much percentage should I increase so that I'll get this 120? This is my question.
20%.
Definitely 20%. But how you can calculate this? So for that, you first take the difference between 100 and 120. First, you take the difference between 100 and 120. So what is different? This is positive of 20. Are you with me? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So that if, yes. If I add this 100 with 20, you will get 120, right? Now, how you calculate this value, this percentage value? So for that, you need to divide this 20 by 100. Okay. Multiply this value by 100 because you need to calculate percentage. So this will become 20%. I know this value is 20%. Why I am putting this value as 100? So that you can easily calculate. But now in this case, suppose if I'm asking, this is 30 and this is 50, sir. Okay. And want to calculate how much percentage should I increase this value to get 50. For that, you take the difference between these two and that will become 20. Yes or no? Because if you add 30 plus 20, you will get 50. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, how
yes,
you sir. Calculate how much percentage should I increase in 30 so that I'll get 50? So this 20 divided by this term 30 will give you the solution. So this is become what? 1010 gone. This is 200 divided by 3. It gives you 66.67%. So if I increase 30 by 66.67%, I'll get 50. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now.
Oh, sir.
Now. I'm giving the another question. Suppose if I have here 180 and here I am having, suppose you can say 240. Suppose this is the question. Okay. I need to calculate how much percentage should I increase in 180 so that I'll get 240. For that, you need to take the difference first. And this difference is 60. Because if you add this 60 in this, you will get 240. So how I can calculate this value percentage? For that, we need to divide this 60 by 180 and multiply this value by 100. So 6 61 जा 60, 63 जा 1 by 3, it means to say that it is 33.33%. So this is how much if I increase my 180%, 180 rupees by 33.33%, I'll get 240. Now I'm now come to the question which I already asked to you. My question was B salary is 20% higher than A salary. So this is A person and this is person B. Okay. So I said that B salary is 20% higher than A salary. So if I have this 100, if suppose A salary is 100, how much B getting? So B is 20% higher than A. So this is 20% increases the value. So what is 20% this value? You need to add both value. You will get 120. So now I have one thing. A salary, if A salary is 100, what is B salary? B salary is 120. Now the question was how much A salary is lesser than B salary. This is the question. Okay, so look at here. I am going to compare this. A salary is how much lesser than B. So in this you need to take, I need to calculate this value, how much this percentage lesser than A salary is getting lesser than B. So you need to calculate this percentage value. So first you take the difference between these two. So difference is negative 20. Why negative 20? Because if you subtract final minus initial, you will get minus 20. Now this minus 20 with this 120, you need to divide. So 20 divided by 120, multiply this value by 100, you will get 1 by 6, and 1 by 6 means 16.67%. So it means that A salary is 16.67% lesser than B salary. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
The same question I am repeating. Suppose if I am asking that B salary is 30% higher than A salary. So how much A salary less than B salary? Not always 30%. You need to calculate it. So suppose A salary is 100. How much B getting? B getting 130, because B salary is 30% higher than A salary. So you need to calculate 30% of this. You will get 130. Now how much A salary is less than B salary? So what is A getting? A getting 100. So you need to take the difference. This difference is 30. So minus 30 means to say you need to down this arrow. Okay. So this 30 divide by 130, multiply this value by 100. So this gone. You have 300 divided by 13. If you divide this value, what you will get? 23.07%. So this is 23.07% lesser than B salary. So how much A getting? A is getting 23.07% lesser than B salary. Are you following the concept?
Yes, sir.
Please note down this. Both the question, you note down. For this and this. Okay. Now one question for practice. Okay. Now note down this question. Question is if B salary, note down this question, if B salary is 25% more than, if B salary is 25% more than A salary, then how much A salary less than B salary, less than B salaries? This is the question, right? Now give me the answer. If A salary is 25% more than B salary, then how much A salary is less than B salary, that you need to calculate. Okay.
Sir, 20%.
Okay. So one student replies, sir, 20%. Okay. What is your name, dear?
Sir, Prakhar.
Prakhar said 20% is the answer. Means B salary, A salary is 20% less than B salary. How many of you agree with this result?
Me.
Got the same answer.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
20%.
20%.
20%.
Okay, so now I'm going to solve this. Okay, fine. So if this is A and this is B, the same concept I am applying over here. If A is getting 100, then B is getting 125. Yes or no? Because B salary is 25% more than A salary. So you need to, means 25% higher means you need to calculate 25% of this value, which is 25. You need to add, you will get this. Now, question is, how much A salary less than B salary? So A is getting 100, 125, so minus 25. That means you need to down the arrow, means A is getting less than B salary with some amount. So how you calculate 25 divided by 125? Means this value divided by this value multiply by 100. 155 means 20%. So 20% A is getting 20% less than B salary. Clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, dear. Now, actually, I just want to give you one table for which give you the fractional value of percentage, and it make you very faster in calculation if you learn this table. For example, in previous question, the value is 3 by 13. Okay. In this previous question, the value is 1 by 6. Okay. So, if such fractional value come, then how I can give directly this value? Because this is not I learned. I not divided this value by this and I'm getting this. Because I learned the table. I know the table. Table of percentage. What is table of percentage? The table of percentage means if you have some value like 3 by 5, if you have, how directly you convert it into a percentage value. So for that, I am writing one table for everyone. So that it will become very easy. Those who want to learn, please go with it. And those who don't want, do you have calculator for this BBA course? But after that, when you're going to apply some competitive exam, like some probationary officer in any reputed bank like SBI, and you can say Punjab National Bank, Allahabad Bank, or you go for the CAT, GMAT, for that, this table will help you. Okay, so I'm just writing the fractional value, and that fractional value directed into the percentage value. So if anywhere you find this 1 by 1, it means that 100%. If you have, you find 1 by 2, it means 50%. Okay. If you have fractional value 1 by 3, it means 33.33%. It means that if I am writing 1 by 3, multiply this value by 100. So you need to divide this value, means multiply this value with 100. 100 is missing. I am not writing 100 over here. I am just give you the fractional value like this. I know this multiply by 100. So if you find this value, you will get 33.33%. But need not to multiply all the time, means divide all the time. So you just learn that, okay, 1 by 3 means 33.33%. If you are getting 1 by 4, it means 25%. If you have 1 by 5, it means 20%. If you have 1 by 6, it is 16.67%. And that is the reason why I am not multiplying over here. Look at the screen. Here 1 by 6, when it comes 1 by 6, na, directly I write 16.67%, because I know 1 by 6 value. Either I cut this value 1 by 6 multiply by 100. I am cutting this 2 3s are 6, then 2 5s are 10, 0, then 3 tables, 3 1s are 3, 3 6s are 18, like this. So I am avoid this calculation because I know 1 by 6 means 16.67%. Likewise, suppose this is 1 by 5. 1 by 5 when it comes, I need not to divide this 5, 2s and 0. I know 1 by 5 value is 20%. So if you know this table, now directly you can convert the value into percentage. Are you following what I want to say?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now 1 by 7 value. 1 by 7 value is 14.28%. What is 1 by 8 value? 1 by 8 value means 2.5%. What is 1 by 9 value? 1 by 9 value 11.11%. What is 1 by 10 value? Everyone know 1 by 10 means 10%. Now what is 1 by 11 value? 1 by 11 means 9.09%. What is 1 by 12? Now 1 by 11, suppose if you find somewhere 2 by 11, this value, multiply this value by 100. Since I know 1 by 11 value is 9.09, so 1 by 11 is 9.09 and this is 2 by 11, it means that 1 by 11, I know, multiply this value by 2. Since I know the value of 1 by 11, it is 9.09, so simply you multiply 9.09, just double this value, you will get 18.18, yes or no? So 2 by 11, it means that it is 18.18%, because I know 1 by 11 value. Okay, so need not to calculate first 200, then divide this value by 11, and then you will get this value. If you learn this table, it will become very easy for faster calculation in percentage. So I'm just giving you, those who want, okay, that give you benefit. Otherwise, you have calculator, you can do for these 3 years. But after that, for the exam, if you want to prepare, then I just give you this hint for you. Now, look at this, 1 by 12. What is the value of 1 by 12? Need not to remember it. Need not to remember. I know 1 by 6 value. Look at here. 1 by 6 value is what? 1 by 6 value is 16.67. So, if you divide this 1 by 6 by 2, you will get 1 by 12 value. So, simply I divide this value by 2. So, I'm getting 8.33. So, 1 by 12 means 8.33. Now, what is 1 by 13? That 1 by 13, I am left this. Later on, I'll tell you. 1 by 14 is what? 1 by 4, I know 1 by 7 value. 1 by 7 is 14.28%. So, if I divide 1 by 7 by 2, I'll get 1 by 7 I know. So, if I divide this value again by 2, I'll getting 1 by 14 value. So, 1 by 7 is what? 1 by 7 is 14.28. Divide this value by 2. To 2 7s are 14, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. So, 1 by 14 value is 7.14%. 1 by 15, again I left. 1 by 15 not left because 1 by 5 I know. 1 by 5 value is what? 20%. So, since I know 1 by 5 value is 20%, so if I divide this value by 3 further, I'll get 1 by 15 value. So, 1 by 15 is what? 20 divided by 3. So, I divide this value, so I'll getting 6.67%, right? Now, 1 by 16 you need to calculate. So, for 1 by 16, I have 1 by 8 already. 1 by 8 is what? 12.5. So, if you divide this value, 1 by 8 I know. What is 12.5? So, if I divide this value by 2, so you need to divide this value by 2 also. So, this comes 1 by 16. So, you need to divide this value by 2. What are you getting? So, 2 6 are 12, 2 5. So, 1 by 16 value is 6.25. Now, 1 by 17 I left. So, I am left 2 value. 1 by 13 first and then 1 by 17 second. Then now 1 by 18. For 1 by 18 I have this value. 1 by 9 I know. 1 by 9 is what? 11.11. So, this value, you need to divide this value by 2. What you will getting? 5.55. Right? So, this value is 5.55%. 1 by 18. 1 by 19, again I am left this value and then calculate 1 by 20. 1 by 20 is 5%, which is half of this because 1 by 10 I know. So, 1 by 20 will be 5%, right? So, now the 3 value you need to remember, only 3 value. 1 by 13 is 7.69% that you need to learn. Either you just convert into 7.7%, it is easy to remember. 7.7%, right? Then 1 by 17 is 5.88%, and then 1 by 19 is 5.26%. 5.26%. So you need to learn only 3 basic, actually the percentage. 1 by 3 is 7.69, 1 by 15 is 5.88, and 1 by 19 is 5.26%, right? Other than this, every means fractional value, it's easy to remember, yes or no? So please note down this table, everyone, and look at this here. 1 by 13, look at this, this is 3 by 13. So I know 1 by 13 value. So 1 by 13 value is 7.7, suppose 7.7. So what is 3? You need to multiply this value by 3, you will getting this value. Okay, so this is how we calculate the faster calculation, okay, in percentage. Everyone silent. Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So please everyone note down. Okay, this table. 1 by 1 to 1 by 20. See, for faster calculation, what is my actually practice is, I know only 2 to 20 tables, sir. A square value of 2 to 20, square root value of 2 to 20, and cube value of 2 to 20, and for percentage only 1 by 20 up to this. But if you learn this only 1 to 20, na, it's you become master in calculation. The next question. Now, this is for you, for practice. A salary is 35% more than 35% more than B salary, then how much B salary less than A salary, less than A salary? Okay, this is the question. Give me the answer. You
Sir,
can use calculator as
25,
well. You
madam.
can use calculator as well. Yes, please.
25.9.
25.9. Okay.
25.9.
Who said first? Elias? Who said first? 25.9?
Abdul Salam.
Abdul Salim. Okay. 25.9%. Okay. So look at the
Yes,
screen.
sir.
If A salary is 35% more than B salary, so what is B is getting? Suppose B is getting 100, so A is getting 135. Now, how much B salary is less than A salary? This is the question. So the difference is what? 35 minus 35. Minus 35 means decrease the value. So we have 35 divided by 135 into 100. So you just calculate this value, what you will getting? 35.9%. Okay, fine. Now, suppose the price of sugar is increases by 25%, sir. Then how much you cut down the consumption of sugar so that expenditure remains constant? So this is the question. Can anyone able to solve this question?
20%.
Very good. Excellent. Who said this?
Yasir Malik.
Yasir Malik. Excellent, dear. So Yasir said 20% cut down the consumption so that expenditure remains constant. This is the same question what we did earlier. How? Suppose your expenditure is 100, but due to any reason, the price of one commodity is increases by 25%. Now, if the 25% increases, so actually this will be your expenditure value. But since you are getting only 100, so how much you cut down expenditure? 25. Okay, 25. If you decreases this 25, your expenditure remains constant. What you are getting earlier? What is your expenditure is 100, right? So this 25, if you want to find this percentage, how you calculate this percentage? 25 divided by 125. Multiply this value by 100. 25 ones are 25, fives are, and I know 15 value is what? 15 value is 20%. It means that 20% I cut down my consumption so that my expenditure remains constant. Excellent. So now for the same thing, for the same question, now calculate. Please note down the question. Note down the question, everyone. Okay, note on the question. The price of the commodity has gone up by 40%. Gone up by 40%, 40, 40%. How much you cut down the consumption? How much you cut down the consumption so that the total expenditure remains constant? How much you cut down your consumption so that total expenditure remains constant? With the same concept, you apply and find out the solution and give me the answer. Then it is increased by 40%. So now my value become 140. Okay. Then this is my total expenditure, which we want to can to constant. So I need to cut down 40. So 40 divided by 140 into 100, 0, 0 gone, 2 by 7. So look at here. Look at here. 2 by 7. 2 by 7. 1 by 7 is what? 14.28%. Yes or no? 1 by 7 in table. So just double is 28.56%. Okay. So this is your answer. 28.56%. Because I know 1 by 7 table. 1 by 7 is what? 14.28. So 2 by 7 is just multiply this value by 2. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this is how we can calculate the percentage value faster. Okay. This is section E. So now I'm going to take the attendance till what I actually cover in today's class is the percentage of the salary problem. One salary increases, how much the B salary is lesser than A salary, and then consumption's value, right? Now one more question I want to give you is here the successive discount is given to you. Then how we can deal with the question? Suppose I already discussed this successive discount question. Suppose if you go to the mall and then you want to purchase some object, and then you ask to the vendor, the shopkeeper, please give me some discount on that particular project. So he said that, okay, the 20% discount is already given by the company. So if the cost of the commodity, suppose, is 10,000, 20% discount is given by the company. So now the cost rupees 8,000. Now you ask, I am your regular customer of Big Bazaar and other, you can say the LG Mart, yeah, whatever the shop that you are actually purchasing. So you said that you are the regular customer of that particular shop. So could you please give me, can you please give me some more advantage, some more discount? So he said, okay, sir, from my side, I'll give you 10% further discount. Then you said that, no, actually I have less money right now, there's some problem. So could you please give me additional discount? So please talk to your manager. And then he said, okay, there is a festival season. I already talked to manager, and then he replied to me that due to this festival season, I'll give you additionally 20% discount. So there is successive discount given to you by the company, by the customer, and by the festival season. So at that time, this is called the successive discount problem. Okay, so finally, how much you getting benefit is actually I am just going to tell you. So suppose the first you need to think that, okay, suppose the initial price of the commodity is 100. Okay, now the first company given you 20% discount, that means you cut down this value, so 20% decreases the value. So for 20% of 100, everyone know this is 20. So you just subtract this value, 100 minus 20, you will getting 80. Now the cost of the product is 80. Now you ask to the customer, give additional discount, and shopkeeper give you 10% discount to you again. So now you need to calculate, okay, for this 80, I need to calculate 10% of this value. So it costs rupees 8. So now again, out of this 80, 10% discount is given to you. Now the value becomes 72. Now, if further you said that please give me additional discount, and the shopkeeper said, okay, there is a festival season, so 20% discount again to you. So now what is 20% of this value? So 72. So 10% value is what? 7.2. So 14.4 will be the 20%. So you need to cut down this value as well. So initially the value is 72. Now 14.40% again discount is given to you. Successive discount is given to you, 10-20%. So now this value becomes 0. This comes 6, 11 minus 7, 4, and 6 minus 1, 5. Now the cost of that particular product, which earlier was 100, now it becomes 57.60. So how much percentage discount is actually given by customer to you, shopkeeper by you, is you need to subtract this value with 100. So you will get an answer. So the value become, I hope, 0.428. So it cost 42.4%. Okay, not 42. 42.4%. Yes or no? If you subtract this value, 100 minus 57.6, how much are you getting? Please, anyone, give me. Yes, 100 minus 57.60.
Yes, 432 4.